Okay, so this is Marceline's closet. There's the snail! So, like, is the snail in this episode too? I never look for the snail,
I know.
honestly. I sort of forget it's in there. Speaking of in there, with a title like Marceline's Closet, and given the last episode we saw her in, I was sort of almost wondering if they were going to tap on that a little bit more. No, it's. Actually, it's an episode I thought we were going to learn even more about her too, and it was just sort of, it's cute, and you find out a touch more, at least on the surface. This is something that I was kind of wondering, like, because we didn't bring this up on the vlog last time, but I was saying the point where the Ice King was singing Marceline's song, I was like, wait, did they ever meet? I don't remember them meeting. And then in this one, when she's looking at her diary, on there it says, like, Gunter, like, that's a name of her band or something. So now I'm wondering if, like, they did have some sort of history or something like that.
So I never thought it was like a name of a band. I just thought it was Gunter because, I don't know, Gunter.
Why not, Gunter?
I don't know.
It's sort of like it looked like it was spelled sort of like the same way Metallica is spelled, sort of like a big G and a
never
big
thought
R or
about
something
that.
Like that.
Yeah, but
Hey, that was her band, Gunter.
Good band name. Needs more umlauts.
Actually, now I'm thinking about it, because didn't she have that whole thing where she was like a kid, and that was kind of like after the apocalypse and stuff like that, and we kind of know the Ice King, it looks like, kind of caused it in a way, or has something directly to do with it. So yeah, but now it's like, yeah, now what is the connection? I'm really fascinated.
Bum bum bum.
Boom! Okay, let's get to this episode. Finn and Jake are supposed to come over. They're supposed to not go inside the house. They're supposed to wait for her to come home.
Because they're gonna jam with the balloon.
Yeah, they're gonna jam with the balloon, which is pretty funny. Drove Jory nuts. You really don't like that sound, do
No,
you? She really screeched when that bird came in and made the alarm sound too. So I can see why. I can actually understand that. And so they go in and she comes in, of course. They hide in the closet and she's singing personal stuff about herself from her diary, and Finn and Jake feel awful, and they're like, oh, let's get out of here, we're crossing the line and stuff, and it's just about them trying to get away, and at the very end she finally finds out and they tell the truth, and she says, oh, that's okay, I've hidden in your house all the time, which is a great punchline. And then I like how at the end they're there and they're just constantly looking around like, you know, Marceline. And I love Jake showering with a towel on, which he walks around naked anyway, so it
No,
makes it even
no, no. He
funnier.
has underwear.
Does he?
You learn that with Donnie. He tells Donnie he needs to wear pants, and he goes, "You need to wear pants." And he goes, "I do." And he pulls out the little silken pants he wears.
Oh, I forgot about that. Okay,
Yeah.
so, well, there you go. That makes still doesn't make too much sense to wear a towel in the shower, but still, it's pretty funny. Then he gets out, he puts another towel on.
Yeah.
So that was all really funny. I think. See, now I'm just looking for stuff. Like, what was in the rest of the note? Because she was like, Jake just heard, I'll be back soon, blee blah bloop blah bloop, don't go inside. And I was like, what was in the rest of the note? Did that mean something? Is that tying back in the sand? It's like, I don't know. No, it was a funny episode. I actually really did think we were going to learn a lot more. There's going to be a lot more, like, exposed about her. Well, okay, she is exposed in this one. I mean, she. Finn sees her naked, and we hear her go to the bathroom. That's a little weird.
The peeing was the one that threw me off the most because she goes into the bathroom and you're just waiting for the flush, but you actually hear zip, whoosh,
yeah,
and not just that, but whoosh, whoosh, whoosh.
yeah,
and then it's like we just heard her actually pee.
yeah, like that was a little weird.
You don't see that. Even TV shows rarely go that far.
Yeah, and it was a little odd. Like I said, you kind of see it in movies and stuff, but it's like, even if it was in like a kid's movie or something, you just kind of be like, that's a little weird. So,
Yeah.
I
And
don't know.
then
I think it's just us, like, we just don't see it, that's why we're uncomfortable, or hear it, whatever, that's why we're uncomfortable. But I mean, it's like, people talk about, like, you hear jokes about all the time, oh, you're gonna make me pee, ha ha
No,
ha.
I think I wouldn't say I'm embarrassed by it or anything or weirded out by it. It's just, it's not something that's common.
Yeah, we
It's
just never
not
hear it, so it's
it's
a
not
little
something
weird.
that's shown in TV TV or cartoons. Like, hell, think back before when someone's like, I'm going to the bathroom. Oh my god, they're actually...
they said the B word.
Yeah, you know.
I don't know about how he...
Sorry, naked?
Yeah, I don't know, because he was...
I'm not going back out there.
You know, as an adult, it's not a bad joke. I mean, because it's kind of like, what did he see? I mean, because it's like, you assume she's normal under there, but it's like, you see she has a bat nose for the first time, which was kind of cool, seeing that she has a bat nose.
Yeah.
And I don't know if we ever saw she had pointy ears either. I think that was the first time.
If I remember, you saw that before.
Okay, but the bat nose is a phrase, so maybe something looks different under there. We don't know, but that also kind of, that is something I kind of think about kids. I'm sort of like, you know, what that just feels weird. Like you kind of see a naked girl, it's like, I'm not going out there. No, it's too scary. I can't do it. I don't know. That's a little weird. You know what I mean? Like, this one had some weird stuff in it.
No, wait, what's weird? His reaction or him?
No, his reaction. His reaction to it.
No, I think his reaction was more... Because when she's starting to sing from the diary and you have Jake with the spoon going...
Yeah, they're already
feeling bad. We're going too far. We've crossed the line.
It's probably a modest thing, yeah.
And then it gets to that point where he goes out there and he sees that and he's like, oh my god, I've gone even further than I thought was even possible. I think that's kind of what it was.
You know, that's probably true, yeah. And I do really like that they're in the closet when she's starting to sing the personal stuff. He's like, no, they're both panicking, like, we're going too far, we should not be going this far. And I like that. I like, because a lot of people are like, hey, let's, you know.
Now, also,
so I like that they have that about them.
Something else you have to think of, how many of your friends have you actually seen naked?
Not many, I mean.
That's my thing. Mm. If you see a random person nude... It's no big deal in a sense. It's like, oh, that's kind of weird seeing someone nude. But just imagine walking in on one of your friends, female
friends.
Yeah.
Naked.
Completely naked.
Mm.
And they don't notice you. So you just kind of walk in, you see them completely naked. Think about how uncomfortable you will feel. And would you ever tell them?
Well, again, that's kind of why maybe it just feels a little weird to kid show them, I guess.
No, I agree. So no, I'm just saying, I think the way that Finn reacted makes perfect sense.
I guess so.
Walking in on someone nude is one thing. Walking in on, like, one of your best friends
I guess
nude
because,
is like...
Okay, even as adults, we don't always know how to feel. So as a kid,
yeah,
you know, someone seeing somebody naked and just being really like, oh, like that. It's like, I'm probably reading too much into it,
yeah,
honestly.
I think you are.
You know, but still weird. I don't know. I'm trying to think what else. I mean, it was funny. I like when they were trying to sneak out. I love them coming across the spider. That was great.
Yeah.
I love the paper plane saying all the things that it's going to do. It does most of them and then goes in the trash. I mean, that's hugely funny. And I love it when the spider bites Jake and he doesn't scream. He just goes...
Yeah.
And when he falls to the ground, it's the ground. The tear. I mean, that's really funny. So there's definitely some funny stuff in it. I guess, I don't know, from the title I was expecting, like, wow, another heavy one, but I guess after the last one, too, maybe didn't need a very heavy one.
But the title makes sense. They're in Marceline's closet.
No, I know. I mean, these setups invite a lot more, but you know what? Maybe that's part of it, too. Maybe it's kind of like we're the people watching the closet, too, and the shows be like, hey, mind your own business. Focus on Finn and Jay. Come on. They don't care what you think. Come on, focus on that. Don't listen to Marceline. That's rude. She doesn't want you to know. Well, that's something the creator of Ren Stimpy used to say. He'd say he got a lot of questions of people saying, are Ren Stimpy gay? And he'd just say,
yeah.
I don't know. That's none of my business.
Yeah.
I thought that's a great answer.
Well, the same thing has come up for, like, so many characters now, like SpongeBob and Patrick. It's like, are you people really looking that deeply at cartoon characters to, like, find that?
Well, honestly,
I think if they're gay, you would know they're actually gay.
I mean, I think part of it now is, like, because, you know, I mean, issues with, you know, gay people have changed so much now, sort of like, you know, well, if they are gay, hey, that's pro-gay. Like,
yeah.
All the people are like, me, gay, kill them all, me. You know, like, when they go and it's like, hey, what, you know, Bert and Ernie were gay the whole time? You know, it's like, oh, well, der, emotions and thoughts, der, you know, just, come on, the same people hate the Coca-Cola America the Beautiful ad.
What? I have no idea what any of this stuff is.
He lives under a rock.
Pretty much.
Okay. There's thankfully a smaller but a population of idiots in the world, and that's... You probably knew that, but that's a specific factor of them you should probably know about. Now, not that there's... Thankfully, not there's really as many as there used to be, but they're still kind of there, and they're fun to laugh at. And when he had to bring it, it's just fun to... Because obviously they don't understand things very well, so when you can point to a cartoon and say that's gay and that was something that was good, it helps them-ish, hopefully. Probably not, but you'll know if they can't learn from a cartoon, they're pretty hopeless. So it gives reassurance for us that they are hopeless.
I just really like when Finn is at the glass and there's Jake, and he starts doing this, and he's like, "You're not even doing it right." Yeah, I liked that.
The wrong arm. That was good.
I liked the episode. I don't care what
it was good. No, it's good. I liked it.
Now my question is this: did she know from the beginning that they were in the closet? She specifically picked her nose and flicked it right at Jake.
I'll say no because I don't think she would have done the album.
How do you know she didn't do the album on purpose to make them feel bad? Think about it. She's got good senses.
But why would she go to sleep and then wait for them to...
Because that would be funny. Why wouldn't that... I would do the exact same thing. Oh, I'm going to bed now.
Yeah, I guess it would kind of be funny just to see like what else they would do.
Yeah. I mean, she said herself, oh, it's no big deal. I do it all the time at your place. Mm. So I don't think she would care either way. So she came up and she's like...
Yeah, I smelled him right. Could be, you know, that'd be up her alley, do something that, you know, like mess with them and stuff. Mm-hmm. It could very well be.
That's my guess, at least. I think she knew pretty much from the beginning. That's why the picking of the nose, that's why the whole opening up and going, oh, there you are, my broom.
Yeah, my broom.
Like, I think it was kind of one of those things, like, she knew and she's kind of, like, pranking them, if you will.
Could be. It could very well be. It wouldn't shock me. So, yes, good stuff.
Yeah, I liked it.
Indeed. Let's not end on anything funny. Let's just stop there.
Okay.
Like we usually do.